Hello, my name is Mike. Welcome to the Crouzet Tech Lab. Today, I have here the new Syr-line 17.5mm analog timer. We're going to take a look at the product and learn how to use it. Please join me. Syr-line consists in timers multifunction. Single function A call on delay, and single function L call repeat cycle. All timers have the options of high power single output 16 amps and double output 8 amps, and all of them comes in a 17.5 millimeter width. Okay, this is how we get the product to our hands. As we can see, in the back there's the part number and additional information. To take out the product, we only need to unfold the package. And now that it is out, we can see that it is a standard DIN rail mount, and the case have modular shape, so it can fit into normal panels and modular panels. In the side of the product, we can find the printed information, like the part number, connection diagrams, function diagrams, and other information, including the certifications CE, UL, and CCC. To connect the product, we can adjust the screws with a Phillips or slot head screwdriver. This timer has the inputs in the upper side and the outputs in the lower side, just as the other high-powered devices. The inputs either A1 and A2 that are for the power supply, and Y1 that it is an external control signal for some functions that can be used with voltages from 12 to 240 volts AC/DC. Regarding the outputs, there is the single 16 amps SPDT version and the double 8 amps SPDT version. Okay, in the front face of the product, there's a cover to protect it from either environment or accidental movements of the knobs. When we open it, we can see that there are four knobs for configuration. The first knob allows us to select the time range that can go from 10 seconds up to 10 days. The second knob allows us to select the percentage of such time range. That means that 1 is 10%, 5 is 50%, and 10 is 100%. So for example, if we have selected 10 days and 100%, that means we have configured the product to 10 days. The third knob allows us to select one of the several functions available for the timer. And the fourth knob allows us to select if we want the timer working with one of the already selected functions, or if we want it working with one of the special functions, latching or delayed latching. We have also available the multifunction double output, where the fourth knob allows us to select if the second output works time like the first output, or if we want it to energize us instantly when we power up the product. We can also select the special function latching. Last, there's also the repeat cycle versions, where the first and second knob will configure time number 1, and the third and fourth knobs will work in the same way but to program time number 2. All timers have two LED indicators. The first LED indicates the status of the output, and the second LED will indicate the status of the timer. So now we are going to make this product work. We have our power supply to energize the timer. We have also here a Crouzet limit switch that will work as an external control input. We have a tower light. That green light will indicate the status of the first output. The yellow light will indicate the status of the second output, and the red light will indicate the status of the external input signal. Okay, first step is to fix our timer into the DIN rail. Then we will make the configuration of the product. Let's say for example that we want function B, call one shot, that will turn on the outputs when an external input signal is sent and will turn them off after a program time passes, let's say like 3 seconds. Then we will select 10 seconds time range and then 30%, then we will be 3 seconds. Last, we want both outputs working at the same time. So now we have our configuration done, and we are ready to do the connections. Now we are ready. We will turn on our power supply, and the timer is now energized. So after 3 seconds, after I press the switch, both outputs should go off. 1, 2, 3. There it is, they have turned off. Now we turn off the power supply, and we will try the instantaneous mode instead of delay. Let's turn on the power supply, and the second output should turn on instantaneously. Now only the first output will work timed. 1, 2, 3, there it is. We turn off again the power supply, and we will select the special function of latching, also called alternating. We turn on our power supply, and now both outputs will turn on and off each time the switch is pressed. So there we have the Syr-line timers. Question or comments? See the link in the description box below to give us your feedback, and we hope you subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for visiting the Crouzet Tech Lab. See you next time.